So here's a few shots of this one on the bottom is an early Irish dance competition. You can still see that informality being outdoors, a simple wooden platform, and the dancer is costumed. It's a simple costume. The rope belt was often part of those early costumes. And on top, the display of medals. So that was like your your achievements to hang the medals you had won in competition on your costume. And on your far left is a small me. So I'm the one on the end. And this was my first St. Patrick's Day parade. I think it was 1981 in Philadelphia where I grew up. And I will tell you that all I remember about that moment right there is being extremely cold. Because it was always blustery and raw in the middle of March, and we had to wear the turtleneck stuffed underneath the costume and the long underwear underneath the tights and everything. So, but this is actually how I was first exposed to Irish dancing was seeing it in the St. Patrick's Day Parade, and then got to be part of it myself for many years after that. And I'm in this one too, but this was, you can see the costuming has changed to embroidery is more ornate. The embroidery started being done by, machines and factories rather than by hand. This was a performance given by the Irish Dancing School I was in when I was in high school.